terms of any commitment, and I think it's all optics.
Mheshimiwa, I said, all I know is your father, so Otiende.
Yes.
Mheshimiwa, what I wanted to clarify is this. It's shocking because after the handshake, a lot of people in Kibra know that the Prime Minister, Raila Odinga, and Uhuru Kenyatta work hand in hand. It made me have to rethink point blank today because I want to ask you point blank. Is Uhuru Kenyatta betraying Raila Odinga?
As far as we know, the handshake is intact. It was preferable, and a number of MPs, including the Nairobi Senator, Honorable Sakaja, spoke to this, that in the interest of the handshake, it would have been preferable that Jubilee do not present a candidate in Kibra. But from where I sit, it is clear to me that the agenda of presenting a candidate was never the president. I think it was the deputy president and his team, and they are trying to rope in the president in all this.
Mheshimiwa, I have to ask you, if you say that Kieleweke were not there, that only Tangatanga MPs were there, from Central Kenya, I noticed only Kerry was there. What are you telling Kieleweke? What are you telling the president as ODM? These are high-stake politics. Kibra is sensitive and very personal to Raila Odinga. Is this a sign that there may be betrayal, that Uhuru may betray Raila at the end?
Well, I don't think so. The fact that as a party, whether it's one wing, decided to present a candidate, and that the president, as the party leader, for the optics, chose to receive that candidate, I do not think that has anything fundamental in terms of the handshake and the BBI. In any case, I think moving forward, it's going to be pretty interesting because, first, it is my expectation that the president would not then take time to lead campaigns in Kibra. Now, that is when the issues would it would be an issue. If the president was to come
hold
to
on, I must stop you. This is point blank. Are you saying to Uhuru Kenyatta, point blank, that if he steps in Kibra to campaign against Odinga, ODM will not take it lying down?
Well,
this is point blank.
I can't speak for ODM and I can't speak for the president. But from my perspective, it would be inappropriate for the president to lead campaigns for Jubilee in Kibra when Raila is also leading campaigns for ODM in Kibra, because that would lead to a clash.
Mheshimiwa, I have to ask you this, because KTN News is taking this seriously. Would BBI be affected? Would this be a matter so serious that it would rethink what you're doing with Kenyatta? If Kenyatta,
so.
On the one hand, is campaigning with Deputy President who is against the BBI, who has called this handshake rubbish, etc., at the heart of Odinga power in Nairobi, Kibra, I mean, I can't push you any further than to ask you whether this is a matter that will require a crisis meeting at the Orange Party.
I don't think so. As has always been explained, the BBI is futuristic. It is supposed to help us secure the future of this country in a very fundamental way. Kibra is merely an event. Kibra happened because my late friend Ken Okoth passed on and there had to be a by-election. It so happens that because there's a by-election, there was the opportunity for other parties to front candidates. Now, it's not only Jubilee that has fronted candidates. Even the other parties with whom we have been in the NASA coalition have fronted candidates. So for me, Kibra is a very minor event that cannot be placed in the face of a futuristic initiative like BBI. We must treat Kibra as an isolated event. We must deal with it. We do not need to affect or fundamentally restructure associations that we have had, whether in the context of the NASA coalition or in the context of the